Hello and welcome. What a great bicep shape. To another Ask Me Mondays, where I answer your questions you have for me. If you have any question for me, whatever you want to ask me, now's your chance down below. I will, just answer honestly. I by far don't know everything, but I do the best I can. As far as I know, and if I don't know something, I just tell you, but ask away. Whatever you want, let's get into your questions. Let's go. Before I start with a question, I had a question in my Ask Me Mondays on my German YouTube channel. What does includes paid promotion means, what is mostly now in my videos on the bottom left side. And I want to clarify that because in Germany, the laws, I'm sure the laws are similar in other places. In Germany, the laws are so stupid, I think. When you want to promote anything, or not even promote, just when I just wear my shirt, I need to clarify it somewhere that it's a promotion. So no matter if I do something where I only wear my shirt, where I mention my 5% code for Koro Drogerie, my 10% code for Vivo Life or something, if I do anything like that, I need to mention it everywhere. And you basically can never do it right. Other influencers, social media creators, they get big fees for just tagging a friend. Oh, you didn't mention it, it's advertising because you tagged him. It's so ridiculous. And so I'm now doing this as a precaution that if I wear my merch, for example, that if I get sued, you wear your merch without telling them. No, here it's a paid promotion. Well, yeah, of course I get paid for my merch. It's my merch. What do you expect? And I think that's just so stupid because in our world, basically everything is an ad, it's a commercial. I go down the street, there's so many shopping malls, and everywhere there are promotions, there are big billboards of something, and nowhere there's a sign, hey, this is a commercial, because it's obvious, right? And it's obvious that I get paid for my merch because it's my merch, but on YouTube, these small creators like me, we need to clarify that everywhere. But big companies, they can just plug commercial everywhere and don't need to mention that, all right? But we small creators do. Or what drives me the most crazy is these sneaky things like the meat and dairy industry does, who pays huge sponsorships, like $30 million to a position paper what the dietary guideline is, and they write it, yeah, you should include 2 eggs per week, blah 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 blah, and then so small, sponsored by the egg council, that no one will find that. And then that is allowed, that they paid $30 million to write this position paper and it's clearly sponsored by the egg council. And there's not a big sign, hey, this is sponsored by them. No, it's so tiny, no one will notice, but then that's okay. But these small creators who just wear their merch, who just give you a 10% discount for something, where I get a commission out of it, which is clear, we need to be like, oh, it's... And you cannot do it right, that is the thing. Yeah, German laws, they're so... That's why I put this includes paid promotion in basically every video as a precaution. So if I get sued or something, I warned you that I get paid for my merch because it's my merch. Isn't that obvious? So I got this out of the way. Now let's start with your questions. Why did you visit most of the states in the US? I would love to hear the story about this. Because I said I've been to almost all states besides Alaska and Hawaii. I think to all of them besides Alaska and Hawaii. And why? Yeah, because that's a lot of states. That's 48 states, right? Or 50 states? That's what the United States have? I think, yeah. I don't know. I'm quite sure. So, because my family loved to do vacation in the United States. When I grew up with my mother, with my brother, with my sister, we all together flew to the US and spent there our summer vacation for 3 to 4 weeks. About a month always, and we always had different trips, road trips. We often did east to west coast trips. We landed on the east coast and drove all the way through to the west coast, for example, the Route 66, and sometimes even back and forth, east coast to west coast to east coast, and different routes. And after I've been to the United States, I think 14 times, I covered most of the states. But it's not fair to say that I know much about every state because I don't, because often we just drove through a state without doing much there besides getting gas and sleeping. And I was young and I wasn't so interested in admiring nature and being curious. Now, when I was younger, I was at my PlayStation Portable and played games. And I was young, you know, you forget stuff and you're not so curious remembering things where they are. You just be in the moment and don't make the connection. Oh, this is this state, that state. So I don't have a, if you ask me, hey, how was Michigan? I don't know. I know certain things like, oh, in Chicago we did this. Oh, in the Universal Studios in California we did this and that and this and that. But overall, many states I associate nothing with that. But that could change because I'm eager to travel to the United States again more often because it's a beautiful, huge, so versatile country. I mean, you have everything. You have nice beaches, nice mountains, nice, so versatile nature. Just, yeah, your Whole Foods, they're next level, your products, they're heaven for vegans. On the East Coast, West Coast, there's so many vegan heavens like California and stuff. And I also spent a semester in Pennsylvania where I stayed for about 7 months. And I really explored that neighborhood of Pennsylvania. It was Westchester. Shout out to Westchester. Is circumcision the norm in Germany? In America, it's shifted to about 50-50 for babies currently being born. But for male adults, they are mostly all circumcised. Personally, my son is not. I know, I recently found out about it. Some of my friends told me who are from the United States. And I was like, really? Most adults? And in Germany, no, as far as I know, it's not. I'm not circumcised and I'm quite sure most of my friends are not, and I'm quite sure it's not the norm in Germany. I thought it's just for Jewish people do it a lot, then some people who need to do it because of an infection, I don't know, something, and some people just like to do it, but I think it's the minority in Germany. And I thought it's the minority everywhere, but that in America, in the United States, they do it so commonly, I had no clue since recently, and I don't know why. Let me know why it's the norm. Yeah, I'm not. I think most of my friends are not. That's something I don't really talk about. I will ask them, but I'm quite sure it's not the norm in Germany. I was surprised it is in the US. And I think people should have a choice, because when you're a baby and get circumcised, you don't have a choice. You should at least wait until you're 16 and then you can have the choice if you want or not, because I think it's really rude to take something away from you, what you might want to keep. And then you grow up and you realize this is, they cut it off and you're like, hey, why did you do that? And I think we should wait until they're at least 16 or 18 and then make the decision for themselves. I don't see any benefit in doing that. But I didn't look into that. So if there are numerous of benefits, then let me know, but I don't know. I'm glad I don't. How did you turn your girlfriend vegan? We men out here need to know. I think it's the other way around. The women out there need to know how to turn men vegan, because the statistics say over 80% of vegans are female. That said, how did I turn Scorpion vegan? Yeah, it was so simple. She was already vegetarian. She was open-minded. Open-minded, the most important attitude to have. And then it was just a no-brainer. I just watched a couple of documentaries with her. One was Cowspiracy and the other one was the Great Speech by Gary Jourofsky. And she cried, she made the connection. And then she did it just on her own. I never said, hey, blah blah blah, pressured her into something. I just showed her the truth and she made up her own mind that she doesn't want to support dairy anymore and other animal products she was consuming, like eggs, because she was already vegetarian. And she just made the connection on her own. I just gave her the spark, the documentaries and stuff, and answered her questions, and it was a no-brainer. And after a couple of weeks we were dating, she was fully vegan, and then she wrote her bachelor thesis about the benefits of a plant-based diet, and now she's full-hearted vegan chick. Oh, Ferdinand, I really love you. You are such an enhancement of to my life. What a nice thing to say, thank you. Can you someday talk about chemtrails and the system Elite, how to not get manipulated? I would love someone on your podcast who talks about moving and immigrating in Europe. Oh boy, about chemtrails. So if you don't know what chemtrails are, some people have the conspiracy theory that planes, they put some chemicals in our atmosphere to control us or to control the weather or whatever they want to achieve or do, because when an airplane flies, you see the contrails behind. And that is, I think, completely normal. These are not chemical chemtrails, these are just normal water-based contrails. Listening to this episode of the Joe Rogan Experience, which I link you down below, really made me believe it's really just a conspiracy theory and that these chemtrails are just contrails, which are clouds. They're literally just clouds. If the sky has a certain humidity, it just forms clouds. Sometimes it does, sometimes it don't, sometimes you don't see them. So that's why sometimes they keep staying, because it is real clouds, normal water-based contrails. That is just how clouds work. And I don't think that they're putting any chemicals in there intentionally to control us, to make us sick. Who would do that? Often people think like, oh, there's some vicious people on top who are controlling us, but that is for me just a big conspiracy. I mean, all the people would have to shut down, not say anything, all the pilots, all the people who built the aircraft, and who are those people? The pilots, those don't get paid like crazy money, and they live on Earth as well. Do you think they really want to get something sprayed that also, yeah, makes them sick as well? Who would do that? And all the people shutting up about it, I think that's a big conspiracy, like flat Earth. But flat Earth is something that is, who still believes the Earth is flat with all the proof against it, is just, yeah, a big believer who doesn't know anything much. But chemtrails, I think it's a conspiracy. I encourage you to listen to the podcast. I link you down below. There is a best of, which only goes for 15 minutes or so, where they only talk about this part, about the chemtrail part. Please listen to that. That is what I believe, that it's just clouds, that it's normal, that it's nothing to worry about. These are literally just clouds. And please listen to that. How to immigrate to Europe. I think it's much easier than to the United States, for example, where you need a green card and it's harder to get unless you have a well-paid job or marry someone. I think emigrating to Europe is much easier because we're also taking so many refugees in. But how, I don't know how, because I never looked into that, because I'm European, so why should I look into that? Yeah, I think it's not that difficult, but why do you want to do it? And if you have a strong why, because you want to do it because of this and that, then I'm sure you will find a way. I have an Ask Me Mondays question. Kiwi, would you ever consider collaborating with Vegains and Scorpion Mind on a vegan dog cookbook? I would buy it in an instant. I guess I have to ask Kiwi, or how is this question meant? That me, Vegains, so myself and Scorpion Mind, we do a vegan dog cookbook. That's something we're thinking about, you know, but before I don't do something and I'm already almost done, I don't really like to talk about it. So it's something we might do or might not. You just have to stay tuned and find out. Tempe question, please. They say the mold is good, but is that true? Guess what? I made a post exactly about that at Vegan Strength. Let me put it up. Blah, blah, blah. Now, how can I tell if my tempeh is still good to eat? The signs to look for in fresh tempeh is that white, fuzzy exterior. This means that the mold is alive and the product is continuing to ferment, but is at its healthiest condition. Good tempeh should be firm and have a yeasty or mushroom-like aroma. Day 1. White, fuzzy mold on the outside, yeast and mushroom-like aroma, firm to the touch. Day 5. White mold still coating the beans, stronger yeasty aroma, slightly firm. Day 7, brown beans visible with mold fading, off odor, still slightly firm, but then boiled tempeh, dark brown beans, hardly any white mold, sharp off odor, may also have slime, soft and mushy. Signs of spoiled include off odor, soft mushy texture, dark brown beans, and yeah, you will smell it. So the mold, to get back to your, or I answered your question. So as long as the mold is healthy, alive and fermenting, then it's good, as you can see in the pictures, as you can tell by the look, especially by the smell and by the texture and the taste, of course. And when it starts to look like this, when dark brown beans, hardly white mold, sharp off odor, may also have slime, then it's bad. But before that, it's all good and the mold is healthy, the good kind of mold, the healthy, alive and fermenting mold is what you want. Yeah, I think I stopped here. This is already a good Ask Me Monday session. Thank you so much for listening and or watching or both. And I'm so looking forward for your new questions down below. Get your Vegan Savage merch now that I put their paid promotion and I need to block my merch even more. Oh, I love my shirts. Become part of the V gang. It's not just merch, it's a movement. I wear 24/7 and so many people are buying it, tagging me. I love it, and you love the merch. It's comfortable. That is so important for me, that the shirts are comfortable, that they look good, and that's what I found. It took me a while, and that's why I wear them 24/7, because it's the most comfortable shirts I own, and it's basically all the shirts I own, because I don't want to wear anything else, because I have full control what a message I can put on there, and it just looks so nice. I feel so proud wearing it, and just the thought that I can, if I want something new, if I want to wear something, a tagline or anything, I can just make it and have it in the mail 1 or 2 weeks later. That is just great. And if you have any suggestions what merch I should make, then let me know down below. Write me a DM or an email or something and I might manifest it, because this is a community project. Get involved, let me know what you want to wear, and I might manifested. So I hit the gym now. Ah, life is so great, isn't it? Don't forget to like and subscribe, and now do me a favor, and if you haven't, then check out this video. It has far too little views in this video. I put so much effort in there and it's great. Even if you have nothing to do with graffiti, I mostly don't, but please watch it. It's so great, I promise. It deserves so much more views. You won't regret clicking on it. So do it now, because this video is over. Thanks for watching, and till next time, peace out.